Hello! In this video, I want to explain a little bit more what does it mean to work with well-known functions at infinity. There's some information and actually many people know, and it helps you when you work with limits or with some functions and derivatives if you just know this basic idea of the behavior of the known functions at infinities. So there are a list of functions which grow to infinity as x approaches infinity. And they have different speeds. So it's very nice if you remember which one is slower and which one is faster. And that's what I call the speed of functions at infinity. And at infinity, I mean as x or input, any input you have, t, x, u, goes to infinity. So as x goes to infinity, the slowest one is log. Log still grows to infinity, if you remember. It goes like this and then slows down and becomes super slow, but it's keep growing. It doesn't have any horizontal asymptote there, only vertical one at zero. So just for you to remember, log is continuously increasing at infinity, but it's slow. So any kind of log, it can be natural log, log base 10, log base 17, log x plus 5, anything like this. That's what we mean by logarithmic function. Linear functions are growing too. And they grow, they look like lines, something like this. And they grow faster than logs. So any functions like, let me write down y equals, like y equals 3x plus 7, something like that, whatever. And they grow, linearly, increasing or decreasing. Then polynomials. Polynomials are something like 3x cubed minus 5x and so on. Any kind of polynomial, they grow too. And they might have a wiggly part like this for cubic function. They might be, looking like parabola. But at infinity, and we're talking about plus infinity here, at plus infinity, they go to infinity. And they are much faster than linear functions and much faster than logarithmic functions. And then the fastest function everyone talking about is exponential function. Exponential function, not only e to the x, any kind of 2 to the x, 7 to the x, and so on. And that one grows fast. That one starts slow and then shoots like a rocket up. That's why all the fast processes are called exponential growth processes. And when you model something like a rocket going to the space, or molecular division, cell division, then you usually work with exponential functions. And that's how you know which one is slower and which one is faster. Do you know any other function that actually grows to infinity faster than exponential function? Do you remember any? You might remember something from school. It's not very common, but actually there are more functions like a factorial function. Remember that n factorial thing, n exclamation mark? That one is actually faster than exponential function. At first, it's slower, and then at infinity, it just blows up like crazy. It's not very useful because n is usually natural, so we don't really use it a lot, but you will use it a lot when you go to the higher level math. You'll see where with series and Taylor expansions and so on, you will see it there. One more function, which maybe you already saw or know, depends on which level of calculus you're working with, it's x to the x. X to the x is basically a mix of exponential function and polynomial function. Polynomial function, like over here, is where you have input raised to exponent. Exponential function is where you have a constant raised to the input, right? And in polynomial, what I meant is exponent is fixed. In exponential, the base is fixed. Well, here we're working with a function x to the x. So both input and both base and exponent are variables. And it's not only x to the x, it can be x to the 3x, and so on. A function raised to another function. That one is the fastest one. And to work with this function, we usually apply logarithm function to it to slow it down, make it more approachable. If you remember those speeds, it will help you to work with many examples. Here's the graph to illustrate the idea. The first one is a constant function, basically a constant, y equals 1, a constant. Then a logarithmic function after that, log n, this one is actually base 10. Linear function, y equals n, n here is basically input x. Then one more, it's n times log, doesn't matter. Then which one goes faster? So here I'm showing you which one is increasing faster at infinity. And of course, we don't even hit close to infinity, we're just at 8. But you already can see the difference. Then polynomial goes much higher, y equals n squared, it's a quadratic function. If you compare it with linear, you see it's much higher. Because, for example, at 8, y equals n is 8, but y equals n squared is 64. But 2 to the 8 is much higher already. That's exponential function. And then factorial is already very high, very early. Look how high it becomes already at 6, or even earlier than that. And n to the n is the winner. N to the n shoots to the sky very fast. So, how do we use this? And also I want to point out, use it only for input x or t goes to plus infinity. Be careful, because at minus infinity those functions might not even exist, like log, for example, has a domain that starts from 0 and doesn't even include the 0. Or they might have different behaviors at minus infinity, or might not exist in minus infinity, or maybe they don't even exist at negative 2. Or maybe at 0, one of these functions actually is slower than another one, so the order changes. For example, as you can see, n factorial is pretty slow over here. It's slower than even n squared, which is a quadratic function, and slower than exponential function. But surprising that factorial is actually slower than a quadratic function, right over before something like 3.5, and then it increases rapidly. So you have to be careful. If I'm asking you to compare speeds at 3, the picture is different, and just make sure you remember that. But at infinities, we can play with this idea when we work with limits or even derivatives or rate of changes. So let's see what I mean here. When I ask you to find the limit as x approaches infinity of the ratio x cubed minus 3x plus 50 all over e to the x minus 3x, you might know now that you can use a L'Hopital rule when you work with infinity over infinity case, right? If you don't know L'Hopital rule, then go watch the video about L'Hopital rule. It's pretty straightforward. Basically tells you to differentiate separately the top and the bottom and compare these instead. But you will have to perform L'Hopital rule here 3 times because of x cube part. You can see it in different video why this is the case. So actually it's not a very convenient way to answer the question, what is the limit? So what I recommend in my classes is to speed up a little bit and just identify who is the winner. Because basically we're comparing infinities here. We want to find which infinity, since they're both infinities, which infinity is a faster infinity, you know? Which one grows faster? If the top grows faster, then at some point it will become infinity over, 5 million, right? Or whatever. And still infinity. So at some point, number sins in the numerator will be much higher than numbers in the denominator. And then you can claim that the result is infinity. If the bottom wins instead, at some point you will have huge numbers at the top, but even bigger at the bottom. So at some point, the function in the denominator blows up to infinity, and if you divide by enormously big numbers, or the biggest you know, which is infinity, what do you usually have? You know that you have 0. So that's I'm not supposed to write this equal sign with infinity at the top at the bottom, but it's a nice visualization of what is going on. Infinity in the numerator will win, then the whole result is infinity. Infinity in the denominator will win, then everything is divided by huge numbers, and so the result should be super, super small, which is 0. That's the idea. And also interesting example I like to mention is what happens if you have a huge explosion in the middle of the black hole. Explosion stretches everything, but black hole shrinks everything inside. So now it depends which one goes faster or stronger. If explosion is stronger than the black hole forces, then everything will explode, right? If the black hole is stronger, then it will suck in the explosion and everything will shrink to nothing. That's kind of interesting idea I was reading in the books for space science. So here, for the first example, what do you think, who is going to win? Well, I want to find the fastest function in the numerator. Not 15, not negative 3x, but x cubed, right? So I'm gonna compare this x cubed. I will say this cube is a leader, basically, in the top. From all the functions I see in the numerator, if you see them piece by piece. What is the leader at the bottom? Negative 3x or e to the x? Well, e to the x. And then I just told you from the table or from the graphs, exponential function is faster. So the bottom will win. If the bottom wins and explodes to infinity, the answer is zero or infinity. What do you think? Since denominator wins, denominator explodes to infinity. So the answer is zero. An explanation is because the what? Bottom part grows faster. Also, I should tell you it's not professional to call it bottom and top, so I put it in quotes everywhere. You're supposed to call it numerator and denominator, but it's just too much writing. And it's kind of very illustrative if you just call it top and bottom. But don't tell anyone that I'm mentioning these terms. I know it sounds not professional. Okay, let's move on. How about next example? Let's go faster. So 5x to the 10 or log? Well, I just told you log is the slowest one. Log is just a slow function. So polynomial will win. Since denominator wins, then it means denominator explodes to infinity faster. Then dividing by infinity gives you zero. And the answer is the same because bottom part grows faster. Now I'm comparing x factorial at the top and e to the x. So if you want to use L'Hopital rule here, we don't even know what derivative of x factorial, so it's not going to work, right? That's why this idea I just explained is pretty good. What is faster, factorial or exponential function? Let's go to the table. To review that, exponential function is a little bit slower than factorial. Here's the graph. You can see those upper functions. One is factorial, and then one is exponential. And factorial seems to be winning and pretty fast, actually. It wins by a lot. Then it means in this case, the top will win, and you will have plus or minus infinity. You just need to be careful with the sign. For example, if it's negative 7 over here, it will be negative infinity as the answer, and so on. So, not only actually the 7 important here is something important too. So be careful with all the signs. Sign will be important. Now, because the top part grows faster. And one more example, this is what we do with the first couple first lectures of the topics about limits when we learn how to compare polynomials. We told you that you actually have to find the polynomial p is here with the highest exponent in the numerator and then divide all terms by this term, by the highest exponent in the numerator, and then do the long process and compare and figure out what's going to happen. But with this idea I just told you can find the leader of the top and the leader of the bottom. And since x to the 5 grows as fast as x to the 5, the answer will be the ratio of the leading coefficient. So it's going to be negative 3 over 10. Why? Basically, we can say sometimes people can mention that in the long run, this limit behaves just like a limit as x approaches infinity. A leader at the top, negative 3x to the 5, all over a leader of the bottom, 10x to the 5, and like all other guys, you close it with your finger and then they just follow the leader. So you don't have to even take them into account. Cancel out, and then the answer becomes negative 3 over 10. And here you can explain, because the top and the bottom basically have the same growth rate, adjusted by coefficients in front of them. So the top function growth is -3 and the bottom function growth is 10. And since x to the 5 have the same speed at top and the bottom, you just compare -3 and 10. This will help you a lot, especially to be fast in tests where we can ask you to find those limits. If you have multiple choice parts of the test, hopefully this will help you by a lot to be fast and convenient, and also to understand the behavior of the functions at infinities. Hope this was a helpful video. Thank you for watching.